This is very interesting.
One part of your policy programme, Liz Truss, which is you say you're going to stretch the debt out, the COVID debt, which is, I think, about £300 to £400 billion over, I don't know, 50 or 100 years. But do you know what long term interest rates are? They're higher for longer term debt.
Look at her reaction. I'm confused, she's saying.
Well, let's be clear, Faisal. There is already
Faisal
of approximately £30 billion in the budget. We are still able to start paying debt down after 3 years. That is what I am
proposing.
But on
your stretching the COVID debts, I don't understand how it saves any money.
I would obviously
at that point, of course, you know, when somebody uses the word obviously, they don't really know what they're talking about. Obviously, either being patronising or you're using the word wrongly. If it's obvious, you don't need to say it. If it's not obvious, you're using it wrongly.
I as quickly as possible is not the right thing to do economically. We didn't do that after the Second World War.
She's out of... She's completely confused.
The economy in order to pay a debt back quicker.
She's repeating herself. She's practiced this line.
And it will be felt here in Stoke-on-Trent. And I don't want people to suffer that.
The mistake that we will make is at a time when inflation is already high, everyone's already feeling it in their bill, interest rates are already on the rise. So into that situation, does anyone think that the sensible thing to do is go on a massive borrowing spree worth tens of billions of pounds and fuel inflation
If we
do that, all it's going to mean is inflation stays here for longer and interest rates are going to go up. That's what your own economic advisor says.
Can I just ask Chris Mason to interject first of all, please?
Yeah, a question to each of you examining your current record and your plans. Rishi Sunak first. Could you ever credibly go into a general election promising tax cuts and expect the electorate to believe you, given how often they've gone up when you were Chancellor?
Yes, because I was also the Chancellor during COVID. And I think everyone in this audience and everyone watching will recognise that that was a very exceptional event that required an exceptional response. And I think everyone will want to know that we get the backlogs down and we support the NHS to recover strongly, which is why I had to do some difficult things. Were they easy for me? Of course they weren't easy for me. I'm not in this to do the politically convenient thing, the thing that makes my life easier. You can tell that from this leadership campaign. But actually, being Prime Minister about being honest with all of you, explaining the real trade-offs that we have to do, the responsible way to deal with things, making sure that we protect the inheritance for our kids and our grandkids. And even if that's not easy, that's the kind of leadership you'll get from me as Prime Minister. But on tax cuts, I am going to deliver tax cuts, actually. We're going to deliver tax cuts for business investment.
He looks confident.
Growth and productivity in places like Stoke. That's what the businesses here tell me they want. But we're also going to deliver tax cuts in this Parliament for working people. An income tax cut for the first time in 16 years in my plans, already paid for, because I believe as a Conservative that hard work should always pay. What I will do, and I will go further as well when the time is right.
And Liz Truss, on your idea of changing the economic orthodoxy, you have talked about this for many years. In fact, you co-wrote a book the best part of 10 years ago that set out some of these arguments. In that book, though, you and your fellow authors talked about, well, our audience here in the room tonight and at home watching and listening as amongst the worst idlers in the world. We work among the lowest hours, we retire early, our productivity is poor. Is that what you're saying to the people who you aspire to?
That's not what I'm saying. And every author wrote a different chapter, and I wrote the chapter on education. That particular chapter was written by Dominic Raab, who's actually supporting Rishi's campaign. But just to be absolutely clear, but what Britannia Unchained was about, it was about a belief that Britain could have a better future, and that we didn't just need to simply accept the orthodoxy, the way things have always been done, the bean counting of saying, you know, we have to just accept that nothing will ever change. I believe we can do things differently.
You see, the Truss campaign is based on trying to steer as clear away from anything else as possible and focus on the economy, which she knows and the Truss campaign knows is going to target Rishi Sunak. And Rishi Sunak's doing very well. And Truss looks weak and wobbly.
As well as delivering medicines out. out to her patients. So I sat there and made sure that it did add up, that she could make payroll at the end of every month to pay for the people who worked for her, that we could run a business that was going to employ people sustainably. That is really important, and actually I think it's an incredibly conservative thing to believe in. But you talk about growth.
She's got no command at all, and then she looks petulant and lost. Do you want a Prime Minister who has command and can command a studio?
This is important for the future. It's about making sure that we can help people retrain in the middle of their careers. It's about making sure that all the businesses here and elsewhere get the benefit of reformed financial markets to get the cash they need to grow.
And we're about
I will bring all of those new ideas to meet those new challenges because of my experience. I'm the best person that can lead this country into the future. That's the type of economic growth that we need to see.
There hasn't been an economic growth plan in the past 2.5 years. We haven't done the things like Solvency II, MiFID, that would have unlocked investment into our country.
Can I ask, does anyone know what Solvency II means? I want to turbocharge that.
Rishi, it's about enabling investment into towns like Stoke-on-Trent. That's what it is about.
We're about to talk about that. That's what we need to get on with. Okay, I'm going to talk about that right now because I need to move on to that because it is something that is very important.
It's extraordinary. even the panel don't let Liz Truss talk. As I said, let's leave it there.